Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, dear colleagues. Today, the international community has come together dramatically in solidarity with Haiti and its people. President Préval's rendezvous with history has come to pass. By their actions this day, the friends of Haiti have acted far beyond expectation. We can report very good news. The member states of the United Nations and international partners have pledged $5.3 billion for the next 2 years and $9.9 billion in total for the next 3 years and beyond. Today, the United Nations are united for Haiti. The international community has acted unanimously and for the long term. This is the down payment Haiti needs for wholesale national renewal. It is the way to building back better. Now it comes down to implementation, delivery on our promises, transparency, and accountability. We must make sure Haiti gets the money it needs when it needs it. And we must guarantee that it is well coordinated and well spent. I want to thank once again the international community for their extraordinary generosity. This is international solidarity in action. I also want to thank co-host Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and the five co-chairs present here for the successful outcome. My special appreciation should go to Special Envoy President Bill Clinton. He will be working with UN agencies and, of course, the government of Haiti in tracking these resources and following through. The plight of his people requires immediate action, and we are all painfully aware of the difficult living conditions in the camps and, in particular, reports of sexual violence against women and children. Very soon, I will dispatch the Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations to Haiti to survey the situation in the camps, assess the steps taken, and explore areas for further action. Today, we have mobilized to give Haiti and its people what they need most, hope for a new future. We have made a good start. We need now to deliver. Thank you very much, and I invite the Secretary of State, then President Préval. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Secretary General, and I want to express great appreciation to the Secretary General and to the United Nations. The United Nations itself suffered grievous losses in Haiti, but from the first hours of the disaster, it pulled together to provide indispensable global coordination. And I know for the Secretary General, this is a deeply felt personal commitment. So thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And I want to also express great appreciation for the efforts of President Préval and the Haitian government. As we've heard many times today, under the most difficult circumstances, with their ministries in ruin, with people having lost houses, family members, with ministers unable to even know who was left in their offices, the government worked very hard to meet the needs of its people and to begin planning for the future. President Préval, thank you for your steadfast commitment to Haiti's future. And I want to thank our co-chairs, Brazil, Canada, the European Union, France, and Spain, for their tremendous support. This has been a real team effort. You see the people up here, but literally behind us have been the hundreds and hundreds of people in the UN, in Haiti, in our governments, in the EU, other multilateral institutions, who have done the hard work to bring about this successful day of commitment and solidarity. Today, 48 countries, multilateral institutions, and a coalition of NGOs have pledged nearly $10 billion toward the long-term reconstruction efforts in Haiti. Now, that is an impressive sum by any standard. But even more critically, of this amount, more than $5 billion has been raised for the first 18 months of Haiti's reconstruction. This far exceeds the $3.9 billion that the Haitians identified as their minimum need for this time period. This money has been pledged by a diverse community of nations, from Brazil, of course, to the other co-hosts, but also Mali and Montenegro, Kuwait, the nations of CARICOM, and so many more. All of the countries and their pledges will be on the website for this conference. Now, to put this effort in perspective, after the 2004 tsunami, more than 80 countries provided immediate humanitarian assistance, and more than 20 countries pledged assistance for reconstruction. As of today, more than 140 countries have provided humanitarian assistance to Haiti, and nearly 50 countries have made pledges of support for Haiti's rebuilding. This signals a new level of global commitment, coordination, and cooperation. Today, the government of Haiti presented its reconstruction plan. We heard from Prime Minister Bellerive a roadmap for building a new Haiti, a Haiti with a vibrant private sector, accountable and effective government institutions, and international partners that would be working with Haiti, not separate and apart from Haiti. This plan represents a renewed commitment by the Haitian government to define needs and priorities, to step up accountability and transparency, and to improve delivery of services. All of us are committed to this process, but no one has more at stake than the Haitian people. And I was very pleased that our conference today included their voices as well, members of civil society and of the private sector and others who responded to focus groups and made sure that their needs were known to all of us. We have the chance not only to contribute to Haiti's progress, but to demonstrate that the international community can achieve a new level of effectiveness and impact, to test new approaches, use new technologies, engage one another to build stronger ties between our countries and peoples. Aid is important, but aid has never saved a country. Our goal must be the empowerment of the Haitian people. They are the ones who will carry on the work of rebuilding Haiti, long after our involvement has ended. Haiti does not only need medicines and surgeries, but it needs the doctors and nurses who can deliver the regular care and sustain a thriving health system. Haiti not only needs new school buildings, but it needs teachers and administrators. It needs the people of Haiti to be given the tools to be able to deliver on the promise of their own future. I'm very proud that the United States has played a role in this, but it has been, as I said at the beginning, a team effort. Since January 12th, the United States has provided already more than $930 million in assistance. The money that we pledge today, more than $1 billion, will go toward reconstruction and multilateral debt relief. And we're looking forward to the establishment of the Multi-Donor Trust Fund. We're going to be led by the core principles we laid out in Montreal in January at the conference convened by the Canadian government. Reconstruction will be Haitian-led, inclusive, accountable, transparent, coordinated, and results-oriented. So, Secretary General, this has been a good day for Haiti, a good day for the United Nations, but also a good day for the international community, which has demonstrated our ability to rise to a challenge of the scope and significance of that posed by the disaster in Haiti, and to demonstrate that the people of the world are united in our efforts to help build that better future. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Secrétaire général,
Secretary General,
Madame la Secrétaire d'État,
Secretary of State,
chers amis,
my dear friends,
co-président de cette conférence,
co-chairs of this
d'abord,
conference,
Monsieur le Secrétaire général, laissez-moi,
first of all, Secretary General, allow me once again
mes condoléances
to express my condolences
à la famille des Nations Unies
to the United Nations family
pour les sévères pertes subies
for the major losses that were suffered,
la mort
and particularly
de Idi
the death of Eddie
Anabi
and Mr. Da Costa and all those who were with them on that day.
Je présente également mes condoléances
I'd also like to express my condolences
à toutes les nations qui
to
ont
all
eu
those
des
countries
ce 12 janvier
who
là.
Suffered losses on that day, the 12th of January.
Merci pour la spontanéité
Thank you
de l'aide
for the
que
spontaneous response in coming to the assistance of Haiti in the first moments following the disaster.
Aujourd'hui, la preuve est là.
Today it has been demonstrated that the international community will
Haiti
continue to support Haiti over the
et
long term.
À la hauteur de cette catastrophe qui
and
est arrivée,
it will
l'exprime bien.
Meet the needs that this disaster has caused and the
Tous
figures
ont contribué.
Are
et nous apprécions les petites contributions des
Now,
petits
contributions
pays
made both by small countries, small contributions and also major contributions by larger countries. This is a heartfelt effort and it demonstrates that Haiti is not on its own and we express on behalf of the Haitian people, thank you.
La communauté internationale
the international
a fait
community
sa part.
Has done its
les
part.
Haïtiens aujourd'hui
the Haitian people
doivent
today
faire leur part.
Must now do their part.
D'abord, en continuant le processus
First,
qui va rendre
continue that process which will make this these millions available, and that is to the review and ratification by the Parliament of that law, which will allow this process to continue.
Et nous espérons, vu l'urgence
and it's our hope, given the urgency of the situation, that this will be done as soon as possible.
La secrétaire d'État vient d'indiquer
que the Secretary of State has just pointed out
l'aide
that the assistance
n'est pas le développement. L'aide prépare les conditions.
Assistance is not development, but it does prepare the ground for
Nous
development.
Nous avons besoin d'investissement du
We
secteur
need
privé
investment in the
haïtien.
Private sector in Haiti.
Tant à l'intérieur d'Haïti
both
de la
within
diaspora,
Haiti and also from the diaspora. And also foreign investment.
Les Haïtiens doivent faire leur
the
part
Haitian people must play their role also in this respect.
En assurant aux investisseurs
by ensuring
qu'il y aura
that investors will enjoy political stability
clair
and clear legal rules governing those investments.
Nous ne pouvons pas ne pas prendre
we
avantage.
Must take advantage of this opportunity that we now have, and I appeal to my fellow Haitians to understand the effort that has now been made by the international community and the responsibility that we now have in the interests of our country to respond rapidly and appropriately. Thank you, Secretary of State. Thank you, Secretary General. Thank you, my dear friends, for being
au nom du peuple haïtien,
willing to help the people of Haiti. And once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'd like to invite the co-chairs to say one by one, starting from Foreign Minister of Brazil, very briefly, very briefly.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary General. If you say one once more, very briefly, I better stay silent. But I'll be very brief indeed. I think I already said what I had to say in my speech in the morning, and I don't want to repeat. I just want to say this really is a historic date for Haiti, certainly, but also for the UN. I mean, we very often hear outside this building, what's the use of the UN? What are you all talking about? Here you have a concrete reply to this question so often made and which sometimes we have difficult to answer. Now we have this concrete answer. But it's a historic date also for Haiti because, as someone said, is in a way Haiti is proclaiming its second independence. The first one, Toussaint Louverture, had to fight with the forces of the moment and had a high price to pay. This time, it's the contrary. It's the independence with the support of the international community, and we all have to be very happy for that. Two quick ideas, which I will mention and which already were in my speech, but I want to mention once again. You don't have real economic development if you don't have markets. So I want to insist, if we want really to help Haiti, not to be dependent on charity, but really to develop, let us try to open markets to Haiti. Let us give duty-free, quota-free to Haitian products with preferential rules of origin. Those who know trade know what that means and know how important it will be for investment in textile and so many areas which President Clinton, among others, have mentioned. Second idea, let us make of this tragic 12th of January the universal date of solidarity. That's not only symbolic, not only rhetoric, but it's to remind us for the next few years that we still have a job to perform, that the job of solidarity is not only exhausted today, it has to be repeated in the surveillance of the implementation of what we decided today. So these are the two things. I think I was brief enough. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm as well heartened by the enthusiasm, the passion, and the commitment demonstrated by the international community here today. Haiti's family and global support network has grown substantially. The seeds that we planted in Montreal, the Montreal principles, less than 3 months ago, are now beginning to emerge. We have come in solidarity. We have given generously, and now we expect results. As donors, we have set a high bar for our own coordination, and we have committed to be transparent and accountable. For their part, we have heard from the Haitians, from the President, from the Prime Minister, we've heard from the Haitian civil society that they accept the need for real change in their country. And to address long-standing impediments and inequalities that have limited the progress of their people and their nation. What is needed to move forward is not merely political stability, but a strong, unified national political consensus.
Si cet engagement peut être réalisé et maintenu, si nous pouvons continuer de cibler les priorités, chaque dollar sera investi sagement et de manière efficace, alors nous pourrons livrer sur nos engagements envers le peuple haïtien pour un meilleur futur pour eux et leurs enfants. Nous avons fait beaucoup de progrès afin de consolider la dynamique actuelle appuyant Haïti.
Trend towards assisting Haiti, and today we reached a major stage on the long path ahead of us. Now we must rapidly achieve results. Thank you.
In 35 seconds, 235,000 people perished, 300,000 people were injured, and 1 million people became homeless. The United Nations and international organizations lost people who were there dedicated to provide a better future for Haiti. Remembering all that, I want to pay tribute to the 27 members of the European Union and the institutions who have committed themselves to supporting this effort today. An effort that I believe is engaged in producing an economic future for all the people of Haiti, and especially for the children, some of whom I was privileged in my visit to meet. Mr. President, this is only the beginning, but I think everyone here is committed to support you to the end of this process.
Eh bien, parfois, on peut être fier d'appartenir à la communauté internationale. Parfois.
Sometimes.
Remarquez, aussitôt on se demande pourquoi c'est toujours devant une catastrophe qu'on réagit si bien. Alfred de Musset a dit « Rien ne nous rend si grand que les grandes douleurs, les chants désespérés sont les chants les plus beaux, les gens sédimes immortels qui sont le plus sanglant. » Pourquoi s'unir toujours après une catastrophe, je vous pose la question.
That's the question I ask myself.
Je crois que nous avons tous senti le 12 janvier que nous étions Haïtiens, nous tous.
Haitians, all of us.
Et aujourd'hui, nous continuons d'être Haïtiens.
We continue
ce qui a changé,
to be Haitians. What has changed,
comme le Premier ministre vient de me le dire, c'est le paradigme du développement.
Is the development paradigm.
Bravo d'avoir changé aussi
so
cela.
I congratulate you also on changing
on
the development paradigm.
Nous avons tous
We're not
été
just satisfied with, and we've
des
all
travailleurs
been,
humanitaires
humanitarian
en Haïti. Ce qui vient de changer,
c'est que les Haïtiens what has changed
ont
now
décidé
is that the Haitian people
de
have taken
cela,
the decision
leur
to
sort,
to assume responsibility for their own future.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you.
Merci, Monsieur le Secrétaire Général.
Secretary General,
Merci
President, thank
Ce
you
fut
all.
Un travail collectif
this was a collective
plus,
endeavor.
Nous avons
and we
le faire ensemble.
Enjoyed
Merci,
working
Monsieur
together. Thank you, Prime Minister. Thank you.
Permítanme que me una a los agradecimientos expresados
like
al Secretario General de Naciones Unidas y a la Secretaria de Estado, Secretaria de Estado de Estados Unidos por la organización de esta conferencia, de esta jornada de trabajo, que como han podido ver ha sido muy fructífera. Sin duda, hoy, ya se ha dicho, es un día importante. Lo es para el pueblo de Haití y lo es para todo el mundo, porque damos un nuevo paso en ese compromiso con la reconstrucción de Haití que comenzamos con la conferencia de Santo Domingo que continuamos en Montreal y que hoy hemos traducido en cifras. Y se suele decir que las cifras son frías, pero yo les puedo asegurar que las de hoy no lo son. Son cifras que nos hablan de la solidaridad de pueblos y naciones del planeta entero. Hoy es un día importante porque Haití puede marcar un antes y un después en la política global de cooperación internacional. Porque hoy estoy convencida de que hemos dado un pistoletazo de salida para que los compromisos de los países donantes no solo se expresen y se concreten en contribuciones, sino para que los proyectos que hay detrás de ellas se conviertan cuanto antes en realidades tangibles para los haitianos. España está satisfecha con el desarrollo de esta conferencia, una conferencia que no solo ha obtenido importantes resultados económicos, sino que ha fijado una nueva arquitectura financiera e institucional que, liderada por Naciones Unidas, asegurará la transparencia y el control en la ejecución de los proyectos de reconstrucción. El reto, señoras y señores, sin duda es importante, pero la dificultad es una excusa que el futuro nunca acepta. Hoy, países de los cinco continentes, pueblos de todo el planeta, hemos firmado una declaración que nos compromete con el futuro de Haití. Podemos hacer, y esa es la determinación del Gobierno de España, que sea también una declaración para un mundo mejor. Muchas gracias.
We have time for three questions. When you ask your question, please could I ask you to say to whom the question is addressed. The first question is Efe. Please could you use the microphone as well. Thank you very much.
Microphone, please.
Sorry. To the Secretary General first, if how can you assure to the international community that the money that has been pledged today is going to go to the right hands and not to, as the skeptics say, to it's going to be invested in the wrong things? And also, quisiera preguntar a la vicepresidenta de España si cree que lo que se ha conseguido hoy y la experiencia en la ayuda a Haití puede cambiar el modelo de cooperación en el mundo. Gracias.
The cooperation model worldwide. Thank you.
First of all, the government of Haiti and its donor partners are accountable to the people of Haiti to be transparent and effective and accountable. And Haitian government are also accountable to the international community, and international community are also accountable to Haitian government and people. We have agreed to a robust internet-based tracking system to report on the delivery of their assistance and an emphasis on measuring performance and results. The pledge will be published and assistance flows tracked through a web-based system being established by the United Nations with the current, with the government of Haiti. As I said in my remarks, the Office of the Special Envoy, President Clinton, and UNDP will be responsible for that. This information will be available to the public, and the system was done to improve on past practice and ensure accountability and transparency. What is, again, more important is that the pledges should be delivered in time so that when the government of Haiti needs, then they should be able to use it. That's mutual accountability.
Yo creo que sí que Haití puede marcar un antes y un después en la política global de cooperación internacional. ¿Y por qué lo creo? Porque creo que hemos hecho un buen trabajo.
I believe that because hoy se ha llegado a esta conferencia
tras un trabajo previo que ha ido precedido de reuniones para realizar un diagnóstico de situación y fijar unas necesidades. Reuniones en las que ha participado no solo las instituciones, los países donantes, sino la sociedad civil. Han participado los empresarios, han participado los gobiernos locales,
business people,
han participado
local governments,
las organizaciones no gubernamentales.
Y con el plan,
definido por el gobierno de Haití, se ha determinado y se ha hecho un diagnóstico de situación. A partir de ahí, hemos fijado una nueva arquitectura financiera, una nueva arquitectura institucional para llevar a cabo ese plan.
In order to follow
control,
up on the plan.
Transparencia,
control, transparency, and coordination.
And
quite honestly, I believe that with these parameters, we can move forward in a more effective way with this new global model for international cooperation.
Next, Andy Quinn from Reuters.
Question for the Secretary of State Clinton. Madam Secretary, on Haiti, I'm wondering if you can tell us if Prime Minister Bellerive's request for $350 million in direct budget support has been covered, and what needs to be done immediately to improve the government's functions in Haiti. And if you'll allow me to ask a question on Iran, we understand that on P5 plus one held their conference call today and unanimously agreed that it was time to move on to a new phase discussing possible sanctions on Iran. Can you tell us what was agreed, how soon ambassadors in New York will meet to begin the negotiations, and what this may mean for President Obama's timeline on bringing a resolution to a vote within weeks? And for Minister Amorim, now that the P5 plus one appears to be ready to start drafting a negotiation even before President Lula goes to Tehran, I'm wondering if you're still comfortable with Brazil's position, or do you think that there might be, it might change at some point in the future?
Well, thank you very much for your questions and interest on all very important matters. Now, this press conference is meant for discussing the Haiti donor conference. Therefore, I would appeal to you that the question should be directed only on Haiti. And one person, one question.
Sorry, what?
Take it now.
Which one of the seven questions should I answer? Now, look, we are working very closely with the Haitian government on the manner and delivery of the aid that we have committed, as we all are. We are going through the multi-donor trust fund. We're going through bilateral channels, and we will be disclosing and discussing our actions as we move forward. But our commitment is to be as effective, results-oriented, and expeditious as possible. As you know, our commitment is in the supplemental pending before Congress. We want to get that passed as quickly as we can and begin to implement it. On your last question, I think you accurately described the P5 plus one position. It's been a unified consultative group for more than a year now, and it continues to be unified, and there will be a great deal of further consultation, not only among the P5 plus one, but other members of the Security Council and other member nations during the next weeks.
Well, I'll start, if I may, responding to another question that had to do with Haiti, which was not put to me, but since I am asking another question, I'll mention that. And that question had to do with how can you be sure that the money gets to the right people. And I'm saying that because in Brazil, when we started a huge program of income transfer, many people in the opposition or in the media asked, how are you sure that the money is getting to the right people? Well, 5 years or 6 years after that, 30 million people were raised out of poverty. So that was the best reply. So this question of being sure or not being sure is very often an excuse for doing nothing. Of course, that does not mean that we should not have the appropriate mechanisms. We will have, but the most important thing is to have the will to help. And this brings concrete results. As to the question that was asked more directly to me on Iran, as you know, we are not part of the P5, so we are not privy to the discussions that take place among the permanent members. Maybe someday that will change, and then I'll be able to give you a better answer. But in the meantime, let me tell you that we are always open to any discussions. Of course, as you know, Brazil is in favor of negotiated solutions, but we are also open to discuss and are open to dialogue with other countries. Thank you.
Well, I think all the members of the P5 plus one, as well as every other member of the United Nations, is open to negotiated solutions. We happen to think that action in the Security Council is part of negotiation and diplomacy that perhaps can get the attention of the Iranian leadership.
And if I may, not only we offered, but we did. We were talking and talking with the Iranian. We did.
Est-ce que je dois développer un programme nucléaire pour qu'on parle d'Haïti?
Pour qu'on reparle d'Haïti? So that we come back to talking about Haiti?
Voilà. Voilà, à présent, Madame, Monsieur, la dernière question, elle sera haïtienne et elle sera formulée par le journaliste Gary-Pierre Bolchard de Radio Scoop FM.
From FM. Scoop FM.
Where is he? Voilà. Ça va? Ok, d'accord, merci beaucoup.
Thank you very much. I'd like to raise a question which may go against the flow of the question raised by the agence FA with regard to the assistance. I have a question for Mrs. Hillary Clinton, but it's a different question. There's always been a problem in the mechanism for disbursing the funds promised by donors, because often the funds that are promised are not actually provided. So what guarantees can be given by Secretary of State to the government of Haiti so that we do end corruption and that the money actually reaches the people? The second question is to the President of the Republic. Mr. Préval, Your Excellency, what decisions will be taken by the government immediately in Port-au-Prince following this conference, but on the basis of what's been decided at this conference? Thank you.
Well, first let me say that we have applied the lessons that have been learned from recent experiences, most particularly what happened after the tsunami, where I think there is general agreement that under United Nations leadership, the money collected was very much held accountable and results were delivered. We are trying to do even better. One of the reasons we are posting all of the pledges on the web is so that everyone can see what countries and institutions have pledged. And we're going to ensure that those who have pledged will deliver on their commitments. And we have set up the multi-donor trust fund. The government of Haiti has set up in an intermediate mechanism for 18 months. And we have taken very careful, thoughtful steps among the government of Haiti, the United Nations, and the rest of us to ensure that the people of Haiti benefit from these extraordinary commitments of generosity from the people around the world.
Merci, Gary.
Thank you, Gary.
Eh bien, à notre arrivée, d'abord, nous allons renseigner la population sur ce qui s'est passé.
Arrive, we will reassure the population with regard to what took place here in this conference.
La conférence a été préparée, et Madame Clinton vient de dire,
was prepared, as Mrs. Clinton has just said,
centaines de gens qui ont travaillé
by hundreds of
dans l'ombre.
People
et c'est
who
pour
worked
moi
in the background, and this is an opportunity now for me to thank all those people,
du
but
côté
also
haïtien,
to thank,
le
on behalf
ministre,
of Haiti,
Jean-Max Bellerive, à qui j'avais confié
Prime Minister, Mr.
cette mission de mener
who
à bien
was responsible for
ce qui arrive là cet après-midi.
Ensuring what was achieved this afternoon.
Nous devons encore expliquer
once again, we need to
aux différents
explain
partenaires de la société,
to the various
en général,
parties in the civil society,
de quoi
and to the people in general,
quel est le programme,
what
quelle est la vision,
is in question, what is the program, what is the vision.
Comment ça va, ce qui a été récolté,
what,
va être dépensé.
In what way the funds
quelqu'un
will
a demandé
be
tout à
spent.
Est-ce que
someone asked a moment ago
whether
budgetary support is included in this package. That will depend on those
pledge
who have made the pledge.
De contribution. Ça va dépendre
it will
de
depend
lui.
On the donor.
Si il y a des parties qui vont
if there are parties
au budget,
which will provide support to the budget, then
that
part will be managed by the Haitian government and will be part of the Republic's national budget. If what is pledged as a contribution is not targeted for the budget of the Republic, then it will be part of the multi-donor trust fund and it will be managed by the World Bank. The Haitian government will propose projects to that structure which is to be created and the implementation of projects, the financial control, will be ensured by the World Bank. And there will be a supervisory body for the entire operation. So first of all, we must continue to explain what this is all about. How it will function. What
dans les caisses de l'État ici.
Part of the budget will go to the national budget, and what part will be used on the basis of projects to be proposed by the Haitian government?
Et je viens de dire que nous devons faire notre part.
And I said a moment ago that we must play our role. It's not just enough to
des projets
submit
sans consultation.
Projects without consulting other people.
Il ne s'agira pas non plus
no, de soumettre des of submitting the ideas
il
for some projects. We must
que le gouvernement
quickly
mette en place
ensure that the government
des procédures
establishes
pour
accelerated
finaliser
processes
projets
to study projects, to examine them, to ensure
donc
that they can be implemented.
Une immense tâche devant
so
nous.
We have an enormous
nous
task ahead of us.
Par rapport à tous ceux qui ont pensé
now,
que la consultation n'a pas été assez large.
That the consultation was not broad enough, allow me to remind them that this was a disaster. There are people who are living in the streets.
Le temps a été court.
This two and a half months has gone by. We've had Montreal, we've had Madrid.
La République dominicaine,
we've had the Dominican Republic conference, many measures have been taken, and I can assure you that all this was an enormous task.
Une fois pour moi,
and once again, this is an opportunity for me to thank
ne sont pas ici avec
all those who may not be present here with us this afternoon, but they did work very, very hard to ensure that this conference took place and to make this
encore
success
fois,
possible.
Merci,
thanks again. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Mr. President. This was a day for multilateral diplomacy and a day for multilateral questions. We're out of time. Thank you very much.